Welcome to another educational video. Today, we will be exploring the cell culture technique transfection. Let's learn what transfection is, its application, ways to perform transfection, and go over a quick guideline for your consideration when preparing for your experiment. What is transfection? Transfection is the process of artificially introducing foreign nucleic acids into eukaryotic cells, usually with a DNA plasmid through chemical, biological, or through physical methods in which results in the change of the cell properties. Transfection is frequently used to cause expression or lose expression in target eukaryotic cells, thus allowing researchers to study the gene or protein functions and cellular pathways. How is transfection used? Transfection is a powerful technique and has a wide range of applications. Researchers use transfection as a means to produce recombinant proteins or to analyze the function and regulation of genes and gene products through an inhibition or enhancement of a particular gene expression in the cell. We will look at how transfection can be used depending on your intended experimental outcomes next. Applications. Through the introduction of the plasmid carrying your gene of interest, GOI, overexpressing a gene allows us to examine the process or pathway the cells undergo as a result, and the effects the expression has on cell growth, cell functions, and more. You can manipulate the plasmid construct to express reporter genes such as a green fluorescent protein, GFP, alongside your GOI to track the localization of the expression. You can also leverage inducible promoters for temporal control of your GOI expression. With the absence of a gene or reduced expression of a gene, one can still assess the effects on cellular pathways, what disruptions occur with the absence of the gene function, the effects on cell growth, function, regulation, and biomechanisms. To inhibit expression of a certain gene or protein, you can utilize plasmids driving the expression of siRNA to target a specific mRNA for degradation, thereby inducing gene silencing. mRNA or shRNAs can also act to inhibit gene expression, or through CRISPR-Cas9 for gene editing, which can lead to a knockout to disrupt expression of a certain gene. Considerations. What do you want to do? Take these considerations into account before you design your experiment. 1. What outcomes are you looking to study? Overexpression, knockdown, or knockout? Depending on your intended outcome or research hypothesis, what you use for your transfection may vary. Overexpression, plasmid transfection with GOI, knockdown, RNAi, miRNA, knockout, CRISPR-Cas9. Considerations. Knowing your cells to determine the experimental conditions. 2. Know your cells. Every cell and cell line is different. Consider the lifespan of your cells. How long do you intend the experiment to last for? You don't want your cell population to die off due to finite lifespan before your experiment is over. Click here to learn more about cell immortalization. Are your cells easy or hard to transfect? Adherent or suspension? You will need to determine which transfection method works best for your cell type. Any known toxicity and antibiotic resistance? Certain cells are quite sensitive to chemical or physical methods of transfection, and these methods, when selected, may cause the cells to die due to cellular toxicity. Also, certain cells have natural antibiotic resistance, thus this may affect your plasmid designs. Considerations. Plasmid design. 3. Plasmid design. Dependent on your intended outcome, your approach to plasmid designs will vary. Consider whether you need one or two plasmids to get the job done. Is there a specific promoter required? Promoter strength will affect the expression level of your gene of interest. What about your gene of interest size? Which plasmid backbone suits your experiment? consider antibiotic resistance. Do you need to conduct some further downstream applications with your cells, such as drug selection? Considerations: type of transfection. Transfection strategies can result in either transient or stable. Transient transfection results in no integration of the gene of interest or transgene into the host. Thus, the gene expression or modification will be lost over time. This is useful for rapid results with short-term expression of genes or gene products. Stable transfections refers to the long-term expression of transgenes which integrated into the host genome. This is useful for long-term gene expression, and the stable cell line can be used for many downstream applications over a long period of time. However, DNA integration into the host chromosome is a rare event. Thus, stable transfection is a more challenging process as it involves drug selection and clonal isolation to ensure you have a population of stable cells to work with. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more educational videos.